Have you ever thought that you are too far gone to be saved? Or that your sins are too great to be forgiven? Have you ever wondered why you keep sinning even after your salvation? If you have ever struggled with this question, then you are not alone. Because it can be quite confusing, especially when you have the master of lies coming at you on one side and misinformed or false teachers on the other. So stick around to the end, because I'm going to share two resources that will help you in your walk. Now, the Bible has a lot to say about this topic of salvation, so strap in as we go through the Bible to answer the question, am I too far gone to be saved? Now, if you're someone who is asking this question, that's a good thing, because it shows that you are being responsive to the Holy Spirit, that you are aware that you have sinned against God. Remember David when he was confronted by the prophet Nathan in 2 Samuel chapter 12? Think about that for a moment. No matter what you've done or for how long you've done it, you have come to this place where you are asking the question because you want to be reconciled to God. No, you need to be reconciled to God. There are people in the grave that no longer have the opportunity. And then there are those who simply refuse to ever reason within themselves this all-important question. But you are. So let's see what the Bible says. This is God speaking to Ezekiel in chapter 33. Son of man, give your people this message. The righteous behavior of righteous people will not save them if they turn to sin. Nor will the wicked behavior of wicked people destroy them if they repent and turn from their sins. So what does this mean? First, there's no reason to overcomplicate this when it's this clear. If you believe that you are too far gone to be saved, repent right now and turn from your sins. God will not destroy you. But there's more. God continues in verse 13 with this. When I tell righteous people that they will live, but they sin, expecting their past righteousness to save them, then none of their righteous acts will be remembered. I will destroy them for their sins. Again, no reason to overcomplicate this. It's simple. For you righteous people out there who sin, thinking that your past righteousness will save you, you're wrong. You need to repent and turn from your sin right now so God will not destroy you. Sounds familiar, right? Let's continue, because God's not done. We're going to pick up in verses 14 through 16. Suppose I tell some wicked people that they will surely die, but then they turn from their sins and do what is just and right. For instance, they might give back a debtor's security, return what they have stolen, and obey my life-giving laws, no longer doing what is evil. If they do this, they will surely live and not die. None of their past sins will be brought up again, for they have done what is just and right, and they will surely live. Again, it doesn't take a scholar to understand this. If you think that you are too far gone to be saved, then you need to stop, repent, and turn from your sins, and do not go back to that lifestyle that will cause God to utterly destroy you. So not only will you live and not die if you repent and turn from your wicked ways, but your sins won't even be brought up again. So it never happened. But please, please, please do not think this gives you a license to live any way you want in the hopes that you'll be able to repent on your deathbed and slide into heaven. I am sure there are many who thought the same thing and they never got the chance. Okay, but God is not done. Listen as he drives the point home in verses 18 and 19. When the righteous person turns away from his righteousness and commits wickedness, he will die because of it. And when the wicked person turns from his wickedness and does what is lawful and right, he will live because of it. So you see, you are not too far gone to be saved. The question is, are you ready to repent and turn from your wicked ways? Are you ready to cry out to God to be saved? Because the Bible is very clear with this. All who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And for the two important resources that will help strengthen you in your walk, I will link in the description. Why it's so important to read the Bible for yourself, and proof that we are perilously close to the end. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord shine his face upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance towards you and give you peace. God bless.